Hi students, so welcome to GOPI Sir Physics channel. So today I'm going to teach an important topic, 8 marks in your intermediate first year IP examinations. So that is about so Carnot engine. So today my topic is about a Carnot engine. So it is a topic lesson from thermodynamics, so which is a very important for 8 marks question. Right, definitely these questions have chances to get the question in essays, right? So Carnot engine, right? See, Carnot engine means it is a reversible heat engine operating between two temperatures T1 and T2. Then this engine is known as a Carnot engine. See, first Carnot engine means it is a reversible heat engine. It is a reversible heat engine operating between two temperatures, that is T1 and T2. See, here Carnot engine means you should understand very clearly, students. The Carnot engine means it is a reversible heat engine, means that heat engine can reverse. Actually, heat engine means it has some process to execute the phenomena in this process, right, to get the desired efficiency. But in this Carnot engine, it is a reversible processes to get the output efficiency at different temperatures, T1 and T2. See, totally it is a reversible heat engine operating between two temperatures T1 and T2 called a Carnot engine. See, in a Carnot engine, the working substance is an ideal gas. So we take the working substance is an ideal gas. That means, see, in this Carnot engine, a reversible process will occur. So how the reversible process occur? First, so in a isothermal process, the heat will be, Q1 will be taken from the source T1, right? That heat Q1 will be absorbed from the source T1 to execute the process. In the middle, there is a process is there. See, first, I am taking the first source, so it is a T1 at the source, right? And I am taking a sink, right? I am taking one sink, so it is a T2. I am taking sink, it is a T2. I am taking the temperature T1 at the source, and I am taking temperature T2 at the sink. See, in between these two, there is a working substance. So in this case of a Carnot engine, the working substance is ideal gas. So in this case of Carnot engine, the working substance is a ideal gas. So in ideal gas, what will happen in a Carnot engine? What will happen? See, first, from the source, the Q1 amount of heat will be absorbed from the source T1, and it receives the working substance. And again, at isothermal process. So same at isothermal process, the heat Q2 will be sent to the sink T2. Means here at two temperatures, the process will be occurred, right? Regard through this two process, then the Carnot engine will be happened, right? The first, once again, I am going to repeat the definition. Carnot engine means it is a reversible heat engine operating between two temperatures, T1, T2, called a Carnot engine. Right, next, so I'm going to explain the processes involved in a Carnot engine. See, next, Carnot engine is an engine which follows four processes. See, among four processes, through the four processes, the Carnot in the Carnot engine efficiency will be occurred, right? See, in a Carnot engine, see, through four process, so efficiency will get desired efficiency. It means efficiency means what? Efficiency means the desired output value. So if you take any motor, so what is the principle of motor? So it converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. So that means if you switch on, what will happen? The motor takes the water from the well and it sends to the other substances like that. So efficiency means in a car, every engine has some efficiency, right? In a Carnot engine, we get output by carried out the process, right? That processes can be retraced back again and again according to our convenience, right? So see here, in a Carnot engine, through four process efficiency will get. See, the efficiency of Carnot engine formula is, so eta is equal to W by Q1. That means efficiency means it is equation number 1. So efficiency means it is output by input. See, W here is W by Q1. W means the work done. See, we are going to heat Q1. Heat Q1, how much work will be done? Right? That is the efficiency we are going to calculate. Right? The next one is, in a Carnot engine, so there is a one cycle. Right? Regarding this cycle, the Carnot engine efficiency will be dependent. Right? So in a Carnot engine, only four processes will be carried out, right? First process, I'm going to write it down. First process is isothermal process. First one is isothermal process. And the second one is, sorry, it is not process, it is expansion. So it is isothermal expansion. Second one is adiabatic expansion. It is adiabatic expansion. And the third one is, the first one is isothermal expansion, and the second one is adiabatic expansion, and third one is isothermal compression. So third one is isothermal compression, then fourth one is adiabatic compression. The fourth one is adiabatic compression. See, students, these through four processes, Carnot engine cycle will be dependent. Means by these four processes, the Carnot engine will work. Carnot engine, inside of the Carnot engine, these four processes will be happen. Right? First, regarding isothermal expansion. So next, adiabatic expansion. Third one is isothermal compression. Fourth one is adiabatic compression. See, through these four, the Carnot engine will work. Let us see how this Carnot engine will work through these four, right? The first one is isothermal expansion, right? Isothermal expansion. See, isothermal expansion means, consider an ideal gas. So consider an ideal gas expands isothermally, then work done by a gas during this change means that isothermal change. So it is isothermal expansion. Is so W1 is equal to Q1 is equal to so nRT1 log E of V2 by V1, equation number 1. See, in a Carnot engine, the first expansion is through this first expansion, the Carnot engine will going to happen the process, right? First process, first expansion is isothermal expansion. See, consider an ideal gas expands isothermally, right? That gas is going to expand isothermally, right? Isothermally expands, then work done by a gas during this change is W1 is equal to Q1 is equal to nRT1, so log E V2 by V1. So this is the work, this is the work done by a gas, this is the work done formula during the isothermal expansion. So next, we are going to plot the graph for this Carnot engine cycle, right? So first, I'm going to draw a graph for this Carnot engine. See, first I'm going to take a graph, see here. So graph, see, actually Carnot engine has four processes, isothermal expansion and adiabatic expansion, isothermal compression and adiabatic compression. These four processes, I'm going to plot the graphs for these four processes, right? Four expansions, right? First I'm taking so PV graph. So this is a P and this is a V. Why I'm going to take only PV, right? In a thermodynamic system, the state variables are three: pressure, volume, temperature. So in a thermodynamic system, every process will be carried out by three variables, that is pressure, volume, temperature, according to situation, according to process. So we will take the graphs between PV, right? So first I'm going to take a first expansion, that is isothermal expansion, right? Isothermal expansion means so it is at a constant temperature, and it will maintain a constant temperature, right? It constant temperature means see, it is isothermal expansion. At a constant temperature, the remaining P and V will be changed, right? Isothermally expansion means it is thermally constant, but not pressure and volume, right? See here, first, the plot of the graph is the structure. The orientation of the graph is like this isothermal expansion. If you take a values, PV, right? So this is a 1 and this is a 2. And the process is like this, and towards the positive. Right, I'm considering the initial values of state variables, that is pressure, volume, temperature. So P1, V1 and T1. Next, it is isothermally expansion means the temperature will be constant, then it is remaining everything will be changed. P2, V2 and T1. Understood how the P2, V2, T1? Actually, I'm considering the initial values of state variables pressure, volume, temperature. P1, V1, T1. Next, it is isothermally expansion. It is isothermally expansion. That means temperature has to be the constant. Remaining everything should be changed, right? So P1, P1 changed into P2 and V1 changed into V2 and T1 as it is remains constant. T1 and T1, right? Next one is isothermal expansion. Next one is adiabatic expansion. In the adiabatic expansion, consider an ideal gas expands adiabatically. Then no heat will be transferred, right? Means we never get the heat from source, or we never send any heat to the sink, that is T2, right? That means the orientation of graph is like this. So this is the orientation of graph. This is a 3. See here, actually adiabatic expansion means what I have told you, it is no heat transfers or releases. See, means everything will be changed. P2 as a P3 and V2 as V3 and T1 as a T2. So this is the state variables involved in a adiabatic expansion. Right. Next one is, it is adiabatic expansion. Next one is isothermal compression. Isothermal compression means it is isothermally compression. Means it is constant thermally, but remaining everything will be changed. That orientation of graph, if we take a values like this. So this is a, or this is the plotting graph of isothermal compression. See here, P3, V3, T2. So here, changed as P3, changed as a P4. Next, V3 changed as a V4. And T2, same as it is, T2. Right? The next one is, last one is adiabatic compression, right? The fourth process that the reversible heat engine can take place is adiabatic compression. See, in adiabatic compression, so the diagram is like this. So this is a adiabatic compression. See, in adiabatic compression, what I have told you, adiabatically compression means the heat never transfers or never sends to any sink, right? The heat will be zero, the no heat, but it is expands adiabatically. See, means that means P4 changed into P1 and V4 changed into V1 and T2 changed into T1. See, right? According to this, so the arrow is like this, right? So according to these four processes, the Carnot engine will work. First process, isothermal expansion, and the second one is adiabatic expansion, and third one is isothermal compression, and the fourth one is adiabatic expansion. For the first isothermal expansion, I have written already the equation. So regarding isothermal expansion, so the W1 is equal to Q1 is equal to nRT1 log E into C. Here changing is V2 V1. So it is final volume and initial volume. It is final volume V2 by V1, equation number 1. So keep it like this, equation number 1. Next, second one. So second one is, it is adiabatic expansion. In adiabatic expansion, so work done by a gas during adiabatic expansion. So W2 is equal to nR, then Q2 is equal to, right, Q2 is equal to nR by gamma minus 1 into, see here, T1 to, it is changed T1 to T2, right? So it is T1 minus T2, equation number 2. So this is the second equation during the adiabatic expansion. And the third one is isothermal compression. Regarding isothermal compression, how this work done by a gas, right? See here, in adiabatic compression, so W3 is equal to, so Q3 is equal to, see here I am taking nRT. So what is the constant here, isothermal compression? T2. So nRT2. I am taking here T1 is a constant. At a constant temperature, isothermal means at a constant temperature, right? W3 is equal to Q3 is equal to nRT2. So log E of, see here isothermal compression, here V3, V4. That means final volume, V4 by V3. So next, so W3 is equal to Q3 is equal to, I am taking the minus here. If I take a minus, this log, the inner values in the log will be reversed. That means nRT2 log E of V3 by V4. So it is V3 by V4. See, I have changed, I have given minus means the arrow will be converted like this. Understood? That means I am going to take negative means actually this is a positive. This is a positive, right? If I take a negative means, see, these both will be equal, right? These both signs will be equal. These both are equal means, can I take the values of V3 by V4 as V2 by V1? Yes, I can take. Why? Because, so here I have given the negative value. If I give a negative value, means this arrow will be reversed. Means the totally these isothermal expansion and isothermal compression, both are same. Actually, here both are isothermal only, right? But it is a expansion, it is a compression, right? I can equal both. That means, so I am writing here. So W3 is equal to, so Q3 is equal to minus nRT2. So log E of V2 by V1. This is equation number 3. Right. So remember very careful the three equations. First one is nRT1 log E V2 by V1. Next one is nR gamma minus 1 T1 minus T2. And the third one is nRT minus nRT2. So minus nRT2. So minus nRT2 log E V2 by V1. And the fourth process is, I am writing here, and the fourth process is adiabatic compression. And the fourth process is adiabatic compression. See, in adiabatic compression, W4 is equal to, so Q4 is equal to nR by gamma minus 1 into, see here, so T2 and T1, it is changed into T2, T1, so T2 minus T1. right? I want to equal both the adiabatic expansion and adiabatic compression, but the negative, but the opposite signs are there. I'm going to equal that. How? So is equal to n r by gamma minus 1 into, I'm taking a minus common, minus common. If I take a minus common, it is t1 minus t2, right? Then you bring this minus in before, right? So minus n r by gamma minus 1 into t1 minus t2. So this is w4, this is w4, right? What I'm going, next process is, I'm going to adding these four processes, right? That is nothing but a total work done by a Carnot engine, right? So I'm going to add these four work done, right? So then total work done, W is equal to W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus W4, right? W is equal to, what is W1? So nRT1 log E V2 by V1 plus, what is W2? So W2 is equal to nR by gamma minus 1 into T1 minus T2. Then what is W3? W3 is equal to minus nRT2 log E. So minus nRT2, so log E and V2 by V1. Next, so what is W4? So W4 here. So W4 is equal to here. So minus nR by, so gamma minus 1 into T1 minus T2. So this is four process I have just added, right? See here, plus nR T1 log E V2, then plus nR gamma minus 1 T1 minus T2, and minus nR by gamma minus 1 T1 minus T2 gets cancelled, right? Plus 2 minus. And see here, from which nR log E V2 by V1, nR log E V2 by V1. Can I take common? So W is equal to nR log E V2 by V1 is equal to, if I take common from this both, so T1 minus T2. So this is equation number 5. This is work done. It is, this equation is equal to work done. Right. The next one is, what is efficiency? So efficiency of Carnot engine is equal to, so eta is equal to, so W by, so eta is equal to W by Q1. Right. So eta is equal to, what is W? W means this one. So nR log E V2 by V1 into T1 minus T2. So by, so what is Q1? Q1 means it is a isothermal expansion. First one. So what is the equation? So it is nR T1 log E V2 by V1. See here, n gets cancelled, R gets cancelled. So log E V2 by V1, log E V2 by V1 cancel. So what will remaining? So efficiency is equal to, so T1 minus T2 by T1. And eta is equal to T1 by T1. If I take T1 by T1 minus T2 by T1, T1 gets cancelled 1. So efficiency is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. This is the equation. This is the efficiency of a Carnot engine. So thank you so much. So we will meet later. Bye.